How many of you have felt frustrated trying to get your ideas heard at work? Whether you're trying to pitch a new project, get the green light for a training course, or negotiate a change in your schedule, a boss who defaults to no can feel like a brick wall. But I'm here to tell you that there are ways to break through that wall. So let's get into it. All right, here are some strategies that I think will help you a lot as you are trying to overcome the no from your boss. One, reframe your perspective. The very first step to overcoming a no from your boss is to shift how you view it. So instead of seeing it as a personal rejection or a sign that your idea is worthless, it's not, consider it a signal that a different approach is needed. It's a chance to pause, wait a bit, reassess, and find a new path forward. Imagine you're on a road trip and you encounter a detour, right? It happens. It might be frustrating at first, but it doesn't mean that you can't reach your destination, right? You simply need to find an alternate route. Similarly, a no at work doesn't mean your goal is unattainable. It just means you need to be a little bit flexible and explore different options. So a no isn't necessarily a personal attack or a sign of failure. It's often a starting point for a deeper conversation. Look at it as an opportunity. Think of it like a road sign that says detour. It doesn't mean the journey is over. It just means that the route needs some adjusting. Two, practice empathy and curiosity. The second step is to respond with empathy and curiosity. So instead of getting defensive or irritated or frustrated, try to understand your boss's perspective. Put yourself in their shoes and consider what factors might be influencing their decision. Are they worried about the budget, the workload, or how this might impact their team? A simple phrase like, "I understand your concerns about," shows that you're listening and that you respect their opinion. And then following up with a curious, "What if?" question can open the door to a productive conversation. For example, if they're concerned about the timing of a project, you could suggest, "I understand your concern about the timing. What if we phase the project in over 2 quarters instead of one?" This demonstrates your flexibility and willingness to find a solution that works for everyone. Instead of reacting with irritation, try to understand their point of view and their perspective. What might be driving their hesitation? Maybe they're worried about the budget, right? The workload, or even their own reputation. So again, that simple, "I understand," followed by a curious, "What if?" question can really open up the dialogue for some collaborative conversation. Number three, dig deeper with why not. So the third step is to dig deeper with the question, why not? This can be a powerful tool for uncovering the real reasons behind your boss's hesitation, because at the get-go, it might not be that clear to you and you might take it personally, which again, don't. So asking why not is this crucial question, and doing it with genuine curiosity and openness, not as an accusation or a challenge, will actually help you understand their perspective that much more. Your tone should be one of inquiry and a desire to understand their perspective better. Not accusatory, not defensive, right? Not putting them on the spot or making them feel uncomfortable, but really trying to understand. So when asked sincerely, why not, can reveal underlying concerns, constraints, or priorities that you might not have actually considered at all. This information then can be used to tailor your proposal, address their concerns directly, and then find a way to move forward that aligns with their goals and their priorities. So this question, why not, can be a powerful tool, but it's really all in the delivery. So I really encourage you to ask it with genuine curiosity, not accusation. It can help uncover the real obstacles and give you clues on how to address them. Four, make it easy to say yes. when presenting your idea to your boss, aim for a yes by breaking down your proposal into smaller and manageable steps. Begin with a broad question or a statement that focuses on the problem or opportunity, making it difficult for your boss to disagree. As you gain their agreement, gradually introduce the more specific details of the proposal. This approach allows your boss to become comfortable with the concept before committing to the full scope, creating a sense of collaboration and increasing the likelihood of getting their approval. So again, think about breaking down your proposal into smaller, bite-sized, more digestible chunks. Start with that broad question that's super hard to refuse, and then gradually pepper in and introduce some more specific details as your boss becomes more receptive. Think of it as building a bridge, one step at a time. 5, become a trusted resource. Position yourself as a valuable asset to your boss by consistently sharing relevant information and insights on topics that matter to them. Over time, this establishes you as a knowledgeable and reliable source that they can trust. When the time comes to present your idea, you'll already have a track record of expertise, making your proposal more credible. Additionally, consider discussing your idea with a colleague whom your boss trusts and respects as well. And if they see merit in your proposal, their support can significantly influence your boss's decision, lending further credibility to your idea. Share relevant information and insights with your boss on a regular basis. When you're ready to pitch your idea, you'll already have established yourself as an expert. And as I mentioned, you can also try pre-selling your idea to a colleague that your boss really likes and trusts. Their endorsement can carry significant weight. Remember, it's not always about you, okay? It's important to remember that your boss is human too. They have good days and they have bad days, just like everyone else. Sometimes their no might have nothing to do with your idea and have everything to do with their own stress levels or personal challenges. So don't jump to conclusions or take it personally. Instead, practice patience, empathy, and persistence. Give your boss some time and some space, and then revisit the conversation later when they're in a better headspace. Be willing to adapt your approach, offering alternative solutions or compromises that address their concerns. Sometimes your boss might simply say no because they're having a bad day, right? Or they might be feeling overwhelmed. So don't take it personally. Be patient, be persistent, be kind, be curious, be open, be flexible in your approach, okay? Here are some concrete strategies that you can start implementing right now. 1, prepare a one-page idea resume summarizing your proposal and its potential impact. 2, set checkpoints for your idea, starting with small, achievable goals. 3, practice using we language to foster a sense of collaboration. Remember, effective communication is a skill that takes practice. The more you practice these strategies, the more you try them on for size and make them your own, the more natural they will become to you. And the more you break through the no barrier, the more confident you'll become in your ability to advocate for your ideas and achieve your goals. And my friends, if you're looking to enhance your communication skills and social fluency for better work and life outcomes, then Exploring Academy is your answer. We are a professional development platform designed to help you unlock your full potential. Our self-study program offers a comprehensive learning experience, providing you with webinars, lessons, challenges, courses, and a community of like-minded professionals. This option is perfect for those who want to learn at their own pace while still benefiting from a supportive environment. And for a more personalized approach, our coaching and feedback programs offer targeted practice in small group coaching sessions and live feedback sessions. You'll receive individualized attention and guidance, allowing you to refine your communication skills and gain confidence in your interactions. And for the aspiring executives out there, then you will benefit from our Executive Excellence Masterclass, a comprehensive program designed to equip you with the essential skills to thrive in leadership roles. You'll learn how to craft and deliver effective communication in various forms, including presentations, interviews, meetings, and negotiations. Develop and demonstrate key leadership skills such as decision-making, conflict resolution, and team management. Apply emotional intelligence in professional interactions, building stronger relationships, and fostering a positive work environment. Manage time and resources efficiently, ensuring that your projects and initiatives are successful. And foster a culture of inclusivity and continuous learning, creating a high-performing and engaged team, and more. So visit academy.exploring.co today to learn more about our programs and take the first step towards unlocking your full potential. Now, I would love to hear from you. What are some of your biggest challenges in getting your ideas heard at work? Share those down in the comments below. And if you like our content, subscribe to our channel, like this video, turn on the notification bell so you never miss a lesson, follow our podcast, and subscribe to our newsletter by visiting www.exploring.co. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks so much for joining me. Happy exploring, everyone.